Welcome again to Discovering Truth, and I am Pastor Forbes of Abiding Word Ministries, and a happy new year to us all. We're grateful to God that he, by his power alone, transitioned us from 2015 into 2016. It's a year that I believe it's going to be transformational for a lot of us. I am not given so much to making declarations and resolves and all that, but I think that if we take our lives as a continuous journey with God, especially if we've made that personal decision for Jesus Christ to be our personal Lord and our personal Savior, then we are driving along, riding along, coasting along, walking along in a deliberate way, in ordered steps, with focus and with direction, with a sense of purpose and destiny in our lives. I don't believe that there is a sudden miraculous transformation overnight. If God has given me the mercy, the grace, the opportunity, the second, third, fourth, fifth chances of living my life in 2015 for 365 days, 12 months, 52 weeks, and I don't do anything positive, anything godly, and then 5 minutes to the end of the year, I expect all kinds of things to happen in a religious manner, when I really know that as long as I cross that threshold, I am just going back to being my normal self, then that would make life difficult. But for those of us who have decided to walk the path of God in righteousness, his righteousness, in truth and his truth, and in holiness and in his holiness, I believe it's going to be positively transformational for us. In other words, comparatively, it will be a better year for those who have decided to walk with God in that manner. And on that basis, I think it's good to say Happy New Year. As I said in our church on the 31st night, and I've said severally, nobody has an added advantage. We all crossed over the same time. Maybe your watch was faster than my watch, but if it's on the international standard and the deadline, we all crossed the same time. Today is the 5th of January. It's not the 6th in the Gambia. It's not the 4th. And we are all around the same time, evening time, as we continue to call day and night, night and day, one day. And so already in the 5 hours that have gone, 140 something hours or less, the question would be, what have I done? What have you done? Because sometimes you can predict the end by the beginning. Sometimes you can tell how somebody's end would be because of how seriously and sacred they take the start. People are also, unfortunately, have been known to take the start, but in a shrouded way. It's a make-believe way, what we call counterfeit or false or fake. They try to do things that they know they have no intention to continue, but they just do it because it looks like what everybody else is doing, because it's the beginning of the year. But the truth is that what is not natural with you is going to take a lot of adjustment for it to become natural. That's why we say what you do not grow into, it's difficult for you to keep and possibly even hand to the next generation as a legacy. But to those of us who have decided that this is going to be a year and we've mapped out things we are going to do and we have started in the first 5 days and we are making adjustments as difficult, as painful, as hard and as unlike us they are, it's a good sign. But there is a caution. I believe that it's always good to have cautions in life because that's what makes it possible for you to drive from, say, Banjul to Serekunda peacefully without hindrance, let or an accident. Why? Because there are signs on the road. There are cautionary signs. Some give you a speed limit. Some possibly tell you there is a bump along the line. Some may tell you there is a traffic ahead. Some tell you that there are roadworks ahead. Some are actually traffic signs. Some will tell you different things. In different places, in different nations, you have signs for ice. You have signs for a wet floor. You have signs for a slippery road. And they, of course, tend to slow you down, but not for long. Their intention and the intention and intent of the people who put them there is for you to get to your destination safely and for you to return safely. Sometimes you will notice that the signs are not there all the time. They are just there for a short time for an adjustment. You see that all over the world. When you don't have signs, it's difficult. Even with GPS, there's information. Even with radio stations, in some countries of the world, when you tune to the radio news, they tell you that there's traffic here and this has happened, that there's an accident there. Take this junction, don't take that junction, take that exit, because it's a help. So wherever there are cautionary signs, they are there to help you. Of course, with respect to traffic, I'm sure a lot of us know of this highway in Germany, the Autobahn, where you can drive as fast as you want to. And really, your life is in your hands then. For you to take that highway, you have to go at a certain speed and above for, I suppose, for you to have the thrill. And so in that regard, there is one signpost I want to pull out from the scriptures. I believe the scriptures, the Bible, is God's mandate for our life, for direction, for guidance, because I see its effect in my life and in millions, possibly billions of other people. I see its principles and precepts being used around the world. I see what people call the golden rule or some of these things. I see them being pulled from the Bible because it's the manual that we came with. In other words, if you want to fix me right, you have to go to the Bible. If you want to fix you right, we got to fix you from the Bible. And so one of the many verses in the Bible, from 66 book, 39 in the Old Testament and 27 in the New Testament, I am reading from a small book called the Songs of Solomon. The Songs of Solomon and chapter 2. And chapter 2, and I'm reading one verse, verse 15. And this is what it says. Catch us the foxes, the little foxes that spoil the vines. For our vines have tender grapes. I read it again from the book of Songs of Solomon in the Old Testament, second chapter and 15th verse. Catch us the foxes, the little foxes that spoil the vines, for our vines have tender grapes. I'm no agricultural expert, and I know that agriculture seems to be an exciting field in our country, and big or small, domestic or commercial, everybody seems to be involved in one way or the other, because I suppose that's the way we get food, apart from other methods. And so when you talk about a vine or vines, you probably talk about a vineyard. So somebody decided that for his or her blessing, as their business, as their enterprise, they are going to grow grapes. And from grapes, all kinds of things can be gotten. Grape juice, Ribena, all kinds of things can be received. And this person who owned this vineyard obviously tended his vineyard and did all what every person does who farms, until he saw the shoot, and from the shoot, after some time, he saw the tender grapes, either green or purple, I suppose. And then something came to his mind, and he speaks to those who are tending his vine, or her vine for that matter, and says to them, if these vines that have produced grapes are going to be a blessing to us, the vines must ensure that the grapes grow to their full size and shape. Because right now the grapes are tender. But there is something, there is an intruder, there is a possible hindrance from permitting and allowing these tender grapes grow to their full capacity. And if the grapes don't grow to their full capacity, three things, at least two. One, their commercial value will be lower than what they would have otherwise fetched the owner because they are tender. Secondly, they will not have fulfilled the full potential of their ability, and the seeds within them, assuming they are not seedless grapes, would impede the ability for the second generation and the continuation of this enterprise and this industry for the blessing of the owner. I'm sure you know I am not sitting here talking about agriculture. I'm talking about my life and your life and our lives, and I'm talking about our national life. We have entered a new year. We have vines. You have a vine, I have a vine. It's my life, it's my spirit, it's my emotion, the way I think, the people I speak to. It's my 2016 resolution that I resolved to do that. And maybe in these 5 days, there are shoots, and maybe there are tender grapes. And you and I need to guard against foxes. The scripture says the little foxes. Little foxes can almost look like squirrels, just that they're a bit longer and bigger. And they specialize in coming to the vine. And these foxes are not waiting for the grapes to ripen to their full potential. Because it says the little foxes spoil the vine. Maybe they climb the tree, they nibble at the leaves, they eat the grapes. Of course, they bring infection and all kinds of things. And every effort of the owner of this vineyard seems to be wasted. So in 2016, at the very early hours, less than 1 week, water that make you buy what you want and not what you need, so that when you are broke, you will sell what you need or needed to offset what you wanted that you never needed. The little foxes that will spoil what you want and not what you need, so that when you are broke, you will sell what you need or needed to offset what you wanted that you never needed. What are the little foxes that will spoil your academic life? What are the little foxes that will spoil our national economic life? What are the little foxes that can spoil our national cohesion? What are the little foxes that can spoil the ability for every individual to express themselves as they want to? Because my best comes out when I am me. My best doesn't come out when I try to be you or when you make me to be who I am not. It's a little fox. And this vineyard owner was smart enough to say, I know I've invested in this. I know it's at a tender stage. My business, my health, I'm eating normally. I'm even fasting. I know that the way I'm thinking, I'm gymming, and the way our company is going, the way we are poised in our nation, the way the tourism seems to be booming, and this and this and so many things that could relate to your company, to your life, to our regions. It's at a tender stage. We must be careful that, one, we do not allow the little foxes to spoil our vineyard. Secondly, that we do not introduce ourselves, the little foxes that can spoil the tender vineyard. Because if the vineyard is allowed to come to its full and logical conclusion of growth, I will enjoy the grapes. You will enjoy the grapes. We can eat them raw. We can eat them as fruit salad. We can have them for breakfast. We can crush them. We can do so many things. In other words, their ability and their use can be diverse. And unfortunately, and I emphasize unfortunately, if they are fermented, they go into another dimension altogether. They produce something that can lead to drunkenness, even if we don't intend to. But before we even get to that level, as you can see, everything that desires in an evil manner to destroy always starts with the seed. So the woman lost a pregnancy. So there was a miscarriage. And so this thing died at an early stage. I remember in the Bible when Moses was born and Pharaoh wanted to kill him, Pharaoh calculated that every child 2 years and below, if he killed those male children, that's fine. Because maybe somehow he thought, if I don't deal with this boy now, he's going to grow. Jesus Christ, the same thing. Herod, when he saw that the wise men that he sent did not come back, he now calculated that it's about the space of 2 years now. So we are going to kill every male child 2 years and under just to get one. Foxes. 361 more days to go in the early stage. Am I going to permit or allow or introduce myself little foxes in my life that will destroy my intention, my New Year's resolve, the plan for my company, and the positioning of my region or maybe even our nation, the plans that we have for economic growth and prosperity? Foxes. Sometimes, as I just said, foxes could be self-inflicted. We brought them upon ourselves. Sometimes foxes can be externally brought upon. But when foxes come, ladies and gentlemen, they are like viruses. Recently, I took one of my laptops somewhere just for it to be reformatted and cleaned out. And to my shame, it's the second time. Actually, it's the third time. I have done it once in the U.S. and this is the second time in the Gambia. Why? Because every time it's done well. It runs fast. But as I work and maybe as I watch comedy and some movies and, you know, you get a flash drive from somebody and you do this and you do that and you lend it to that person and you do that and you download, sometimes inadvertently viruses infect it. Trojans, worms, I love those names. They, you can't lose what they mean. The Trojans come, the words, one of them is even tricky, it's like a cookie. And they embed themselves into you just like virus does in biological sciences. And they replicate in some funny ways. And suddenly you find people who are your friends on Facebook asking you to be their friends when they are your friends. And suddenly you find people inviting you to something when, you know, they're not your friend. And then the bad one is you find yourself sending strange emails, sometimes very sad email, to people who know that you have no business with that kind of email. I remember once I was speaking in an international conference somewhere in Africa, and I was unfortunately the only non-Caucasian speaker there. Every other speaker was white, and unfortunately one of the Caucasian speakers' machine was infected and it sent out a very dirty email, and we all got it. And I thought, wow. Because sometimes it's difficult to come out of those kinds of trouble, because people who love you, who like you, who know your integrity, who know your history and the qualitative characteristics of your life, and they know that some things are not part of you, have no problem. The people who don't like you, or the people who doubt you, or the people who probably have some racial tendency would want to swear by everything that came from you. But you see, if I had kept back to my machine, if I had kept that machine, that, okay, I'm making this decision, now that it's been cleaned out, certain things are not going to be a part of it. I'm not going to bring people's hard drive, no matter the work they give me. You know, it would last. Because once the virus comes in, once that worm comes in, once that Trojan comes in, it's like the little foxes. It spoils the vine. And unfortunately, to you and your machine, it looks okay. Until you want to do something for someone and you give them a flash and they put it in their machine and whoops, this thing is infected. Now that could be the dividing line between a lot of money you could have had and money you'll never get because of a little fox. Foxes, when they come into our lives, they slow our progress like the computer. They cause us to start again. They cause us to reinvest hugely. They cause us almost to start again on something which we are already starting to have progress. If it's in terms of friendships, sometimes we lose them and they go away. If it's in terms of investment, sometimes they pack and leave, we lose them. And as I like to tell people, you know, when people leave, they leave with their money. They don't leave it behind. And that money is not going to be burnt in the fire. It's going somewhere else. And what could have been an added value to my life, to my investment, to my plans, suddenly I lose because of little foxes. There are people that I know who are always in trouble, and who are always having quarrels. You always have to sort out quarrels between them. And when you find out, it's their little foxes. Their little foxes is their attitude towards people, their arrogance towards people. Some of their little foxes is just their mouth. They just don't know how to talk. And they say, Mate. In Creole, we say, Nami Duam. Daraduchigena. But no, you're not an island. You're not an island. If you have decided to tend your life in January and be nice, then whatever is a little fox, yourself, your appetites, your drives, your weak points, the friends you have around your life, the things that are putting pressure on you, that will make you lower your fence, you have to decide to get rid of them. I want to say that in 2016, we must lift up our fence high and keep the foxes away. One of the ways I want to do that is to pray and to ask God for wisdom on so many things involving my life. I think we can all do that for your company, for your school, for departments, for ministries, for our nation, so that we are guarded because the grapes are tender. I did not plant my vine to self-destruct or to self-destroy, but it's possible to plant it with my hand and to destroy it with my hand. So 2016 is a transformational year. It will be a good year, but I challenge you and I challenge myself. Catch the little foxes because they want to spoil the vine. Catch them now. Keep them away from the vine. Keep them away from the vine, because you can tell they will nibble at your vine, they will destroy your grapes, and they will not be able to help you to the next level you thought you were going to. And because life doesn't have inertia, you either go forwards or you go backwards. When the little foxes destroy our vines, personal, company, family, or national vine, we will go backwards and we will have a hard time. So catch those little foxes now, because they intend to spoil the vine. I want to stop here. Until I come your way by the grace of God next week, this is Pastor Forbes saying, have a good evening. God bless us all, and good night. And remember, catch those foxes so that your vine will survive and give you grapes and gladden your heart. Good night.